Over the years, one of the things that I've observed that really hinders people with their curriculum development is a very simple misunderstanding about the role of the teacher and the learner. And it's this notion that when you're developing curriculum, the focus is on what the students are expected to learn, not what the instructor will teach them. It becomes a very different focus. And if you focus on the wrong thing and you use the wrong language, you'll have the wrong results and your learning objectives and your goals won't work. Your outcomes won't work. This is a very simple but key point that a lot of people get hung up on. Let me give you an example. The words you want to do or the words you want to focus on are things that you want to do. Bake chocolate chip cookies, overhaul an engine, analyze a case study, list the components of a sump pump, describe the operations of a heat exchanger, calculate monthly disbursements, install a three-way switch. These are things that the learner can do. These are things that are measurable. These are activities that fall into the alignment of outcomes, activities, and assessment, or objectives, activities, and assessment. It's really important that you understand that you're focusing on what the learner can do. And the reason that it is important is that if we slip into language that is non-observable, we can't measure it. And then it really doesn't address what the learner needs to do. Okay? The learner will understand, the learner will learn, the learner will know, the learner will realize, the learner will comprehend, the learner will remember. Well, actually, yes, you want the learner to do all these things, but in the language of developing your curriculum, you need to move into actual verbs that describe what the learner can do that the instructor can observe. Use, create, perform, explain. We're going to go into greater detail with this in the Bloom's taxonomy section, but this is an extremely important part of the process that I just want you to understand. This is really about student performance, so understanding these key things. One more little example here. Look at the difference between understand gravity or describe the effect gravity has on a flying object. Look at the difference between learn French or pronounce the verb vowel system clearly. One is measurable, one is not. Learning French, well, yes, you hope the learner will learn French in the course, but it's through the pronunciation of that vowel system that a learner can be assessed and improvements can be made. It's through the description of the effect of gravity that the learner will be able to show that they understand the gravity. So when you're working through your curriculum, you really need to understand that you are looking to identify what the learner will do.